Hi everyone, George Firican here from the Lights on Data show, live on location, Big Data London, here with SnapLogic's Nick Pike.
Hi George, pleasure to see you.
Hi, well, pleasure is all mine. Welcome on the show.
Thank you very much.
So Nick, as the VP at SnapLogic, how are you doing?
I'm doing very well. my first Big Data show with SnapLogic, so great to be here representing the company, and great to see all of the activity and people around at the show.
There's lots going on.
And a pleasure to meet you as well, Joel.
Well, I love the presence that SnapLogic has and looking forward to hearing more. But one of the questions that I do have for you is about Gen AI, because it's still top of mind on a lot of companies and a lot of people. And I do wonder how Gen AI has an impact on that integration between data, applications, processes.
Yes. Well, you can't miss Gen AI as you walk around this show. I think I've counted at least 25 and AIs, another 25 AI platforms, and another 50 powered by AIs. Mm-hmm. So everyone's talking about it. And I think what most people will believe will be the most influential wave of technology in the next kind of 10 years.
Yeah.
And from SnapLogic's perspective, the most important part basically that we bring is that integration of both application and data. So right now, if you're working with AI, you're probably doing some kind of assistant type of use case.
Yeah.
So you're asking Gen AI a question or asking it to improve something, and it returns that information back to you. What we see, and I think what a lot of people agree on, will be the real influence of Gen AI on our generation is basically when it starts to take action.
Right.
And the action will come by the interpretation of data, and then basically tools like applications doing something.
Right.
You'll start to see that initially with human in the loop. So people basically taking advice and taking feedback from Gen AI and then verifying an action that Gen AI agent is about to take. And that action will be through an application. So hence basically the importance of bringing applications and data together. That's always been what SnapLogic has done. And that's basically where we get our potential to impact and help people take advantage of Gen AI to deliver real outcomes rather than just buzzwords and reception.
Right. Beautiful. Now, what would you say from your experience so far, what you've noticed are some of the biggest challenges when it comes to unifying data and applications that companies are facing? And can AI help those challenges in any way?
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I mean, I think if you have a look at what AI is doing, is it's simplifying a lot of things. And AI, as it be, and particularly when you see it in co-pilots, like our SnapGPT co-pilot, it's trying to, as it be, make it more accessible for non-specialized users to take advantage of technology. And you've seen that, basically, in every technology wave as it comes through. The first people to use a new burgeoning technology will be specialists in that area. But as basically the technology becomes more relevant and more pervasive, the ability to break down the barriers and the ability for initially basically other technical areas to take advantage of a very data and analytic-centric technology.
Right.
But then subsequently for line of business people, for finance people, for HR people, for anybody in their daily lives to take advantage of it, that's where the simplification and the application of AI to integration platforms is really relevant.
I love what you said. So really SnapLogic is also helping non-technical people use it to be able to do their own data integrations.
Yes.
And how do you see that as an advantage? Traditionally, we've seen that mostly lie in the hands of data professionals, technical professionals, IT.
I mean, you've seen the rise of data over the last 10 years. But it's still very much a question of asking a specialist to do a lot of that heavy lifting. We saw democratization around business intelligence probably about 10 years ago in terms of really opening up the ability to be able to interact with data to a much broader community. SnapLogic and Gen AI are going to do that on the integration space. So the real benefit will come ultimately when you can get a business user together with a technical expert.
Yeah.
And then to produce basically a result which has significant benefit to a particular company or a particular industry.
Right.
And you can't do that if you're running a closed shop. As people trying to collaborate, we need basically to be able to understand what each other are saying.
Definitely.
If we can't, then basically the collaboration and the output is very challenging. Mm-hmm. I think we've all seen the Dilbert cartoons from many years ago of what the user described, what the engineer heard, and what finally got built.
Right.
And you see a bit of that.
The chair swing.
Yeah, exactly. So you, you remember it.
Yeah.
So you see a lot of that in some of the early AI use cases, is where you've got an opaque language that a business user who understands their industry or their business process at a really detailed level, not able to communicate freely with an expert who understands AI, you don't always get the answer you're expecting. But by making it open and making it visualized and be able to talk in a common language,
yeah,
then we think you get significantly better results. And we see that in our customer base. So people like Adobe and AstraZeneca have thousands of users using our platform. And they use it with a combination of our Gen AI co-pilot,
right,
which allows them basically to have a natural language conversation, which then leads to a visual representation, which then leads basically to an output which is fit for purpose. So not only fast, but delivers basically on the original requirement that they set out.
Yeah, absolutely. And I feel at the same time, besides all these benefits that you've described, it sort of also lessens the queue on the IT side for them to focus on other struggles, other important aspects, and putting some of these data integrations pieces in the hands of the business and having that self-serve, that data democratization piece is definitely helpful and brings a lot of benefits along the way.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you see, I think I was talking to Brian Dumman, who's the chief data officer at AstraZeneca the other day, and he kind of played it back really nicely. He said, the business isn't going to reward me for slowing things down.
Right.
But also the business isn't going to reward me for taking unnecessary risk.
Right.
So the purpose of technology professionals is to enable the rest of the business to be able to deliver on that change, but to do so basically without taking on unnecessary risk.
So part of what I do is within the data governance sphere. So I have a question around that when it comes to generative integration to make sure that that creates a lot of capabilities, offers a lot of benefits. But at the same time, how do we still ensure that security, that transparency aspect, and still make sure that we are able to manage those integrations with those in mind?
Oh, that's a very key point. I mean, with technology, and particularly in no-code technology, you can do things fast.
Yeah.
But you can also create a mess fast.
Right.
So back to the role of the data engineer, and is around enabling, but also basically around providing a governance layer. And so how do you get that balance right? A core part of that is to be able to do it in a platform and in an environment where you can transmit or request your requirements for people to adhere to in a way that enables them to accomplish things faster. And then you're able to audit basically and look at what they've done and then provide advice based upon what they've seen. So we do a lot around kind of creating repeatable pipelines and integrations. And how do you make those available so people don't rewrite the wheel every time?
Right.
How do you basically apply your own resources to not restrict, but basically to provide guidance on what is best practice around data architecture? What is best practice around security? Where you get to certain use cases which are potentially high risk, how do you employ a different level of security and control around those use cases, but without restricting the business from innovative? And I think that's the challenge, but I think certainly some of the tools on the market, and ours included, makes that challenge, it's much more transparent and able to roll out at scale.
Definitely. Well, I love to hear that SnapLogic is supporting data governance and its efforts through that transparability, as well as efficiency overall and ease of use. So, yeah. Where can people find out more about SnapLogic?
You can obviously try your standard search engine or ChatGPT or any other Gen AI search tool. You'll find loads of information on the projects we're working on.
Mm-hmm. Great to hear. And of course, they can also get a demo at SnapLogic.
They can go online to snaplogic.com. There's a recorded demos. Put a request in basically to meet with any of the team here. You can see a few of them in the background behind me. We're very much about citizen integration, enabling people, making it simpler, making it more visual. So please come to us and we'll happy basically take you through some of what we're seeing in the market and potentially basically how we can help you move faster, but move faster with taking appropriate risk as you look to change your business through generative AI.
Thanks so much, Nick, for putting the lights on generative integration. Really appreciate it.
Great. Thanks, George. Much appreciated.
You.